Hey guys, what's up? This is Eric Merced here, doing a quick, not so quick, little video blog. I just decided to do something new for the YouTube channel since I haven't done anything for quite some time. I was supposed to do a review for the Toshiba Encore Write 2 tablet and more or less how Windows 10 is working on it, and I decided to not do that video because basically everything I had to say I said it on Twitter. And for anyone who's just kind of curious about how that's going, it's going pretty good. It's got a couple of glitches, but nothing major, nothing that will hinder you from using the tablet on a daily basis. Photoshop works pretty good on it, Manga Studio works pretty good on it. Overall, I really like Windows 10 much more than I did Windows 8. I was surprised with Windows 8. There was a lot of things that I liked on it, back when I, got it on the Surface Pro, a couple of years ago. And I just consider Windows 10 like a major, major step up, from what Windows 8 was. And I think it's a right step. A good step in the right direction. For those of you curious where I'm at, I'm inside my work vehicle. So I'm basically on standby for a little bit. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use this time, right, as I wait to just talk about some of the tools that I'm using now. Not some of the digital tools, some of the analog tools that I'm using now, basically. I know I talk a lot about digital tools, Manga Studio being one of my favorite softwares to create art on, the Toshiba Encore Write 2 being currently one of my favorite tablets, which has pretty much basically replaced my Wacom tablet. I basically put that thing away and I've just been using exclusively the Toshiba Encore Write 2. I might upgrade next year depending on the situation, depending on if I can come up with some funds for it. I might upgrade, might not, who knows. But currently I've been on an analog art kit. And for those of you who are like, what the hell is he talking about? When I say analog, I mean traditional art. I've been on a traditional art kit, an analog art kit, where I've been doing a lot of artwork traditionally with pencil, paper, and pen, old school, right? And one of the things that I mentioned on Twitter a couple of days ago was that I noticed as I'm on this kick, as I'm drawing, traditionally, again, just for this time, I noticed that my style, when I draw traditionally, my style is slightly different from when I draw digital. And it mainly has to do because when I'm drawing digital, I'm more like, I'm more focused on getting things to look clean, to look neat. My wife says of my work that it's like really neat, that it's really clean, that I take time to like really make sure everything is nice and polished. And digital gives you that ability to go over your work and edit it, and you can walk away for a couple of days and come back. Even if you call something finishing, you can just go into a couple of layers and finish things. Polish things up. Where with traditional, you get what you get. You're sitting down, you're drawing, and you have to get your sketch right. And once you get your sketch right, you got to get your inks right. And once you get your inks right, if you're coloring, you got to get your colors right. And you can edit your work, you can fix your work, but not at the level that you can digitally. So I've noticed that my work is different when I draw traditionally than it is. My style is different when I draw traditionally versus digitally. And I think that a lot of people, when they draw digitally, they tend to feel more loose. They tend to feel they can experiment a little bit more. Whereas when I draw traditionally, I feel like I can let go. Okay, I know that sounds a little bit odd, but I feel like I can let go. I feel like I can let loose. I feel like I can be myself. I feel like I can make a couple of mistakes and it'll be okay. Because I can work with those mistakes. And I feel drawing traditionally that I don't have to really be too focused on the mechanics of the drawing and be more focused on just basically getting it right and just having fun with it. When I'm drawing digitally, I'm usually concentrated on layers and saving with frequency. And even though Manga Studio is a really great application for drawing, I find that regardless whether I'm using Manga Studio or I'm using Photoshop, I find sometimes that I'm fighting with the software. Even though the software is doing what it's supposed to be doing, at the back of my mind, I'm kind of like, you know, like I have this thing where you gotta save. You know, you did this, you did that, you gotta save because you can't trust the machine. You can't trust the software. The software can crash. The machine can crash. And then all that work that you've done for the last 5, 10, 15 minutes will be lost. So you've got to continually save. So that's at the back of my mind when I'm creating. The back of my mind also when I'm creating digitally, I've got this thing where like, don't do that on this layer. You did that on that layer, but do this on this new layer. That way, if you ever have to come back to this, you can easily go back to it because it's on a separate layer. You know, you're thinking at a higher level technically than you are when you do traditional artwork, because with traditional artwork you're using your pencil, you're using your eraser, and then later on you move your tools up to like inks or whatever, if you're doing comics to inks and or color, right? If you're painting traditionally. But when you're drawing with pencils, you're like, okay, well, I've got to make this layer lighter so that I can draw over it. And basically the way you do that traditionally is using your eraser to lighten, right, the pencil lines, or drawing lightly so that you can at the next stage or at the next layer, at the next level, you can draw over that foundational drawing. But you're not so concentrated on fighting with the software. Maybe the word fighting is not the correct word, but I feel that sometimes that's the way it feels. Even though the software is doing what it's supposed to, even though the computer is doing what it's supposed to and everything's running smoothly, at the back of your head, you're fighting. You're dealing with the software and with this technology and hoping that it does what you want it to do and it doesn't mess you up. So with that said, I feel that I draw a little bit more differently traditionally than I do digitally, and it's a slight bit difference. It's not a huge major difference, but this is one of the more recent images I've done. It's just a simple headshot of Batman. I love drawing Batman, and this is another one playing with the Superman versus Batman whole thing that's gonna happen pretty soon in the movie. I'm excited for that. So as far as paper, I just showed you a couple of sheets of what I'm using for paper. I'm using Strathmore mixed media paper, 15 sheets in this little pad. It is 6 inches by 8 inches, and it takes any kind of media you throw at it. I like this paper. My only gripe with it is that the ink takes some time to dry up. I learned that the hard way. A couple of smudges here and there, I learned right away that this paper takes quite a while to dry. As far as drawing tools, as far as my pencil, I use a Graphgear 500 Pentel with the lead point of 0.5. Love this pencil, it's really great. I love the whole grip here, and it makes it really nice grip for drawing. And it's a mechanical pencil. As far as erasers go, I'm using the old kneaded eraser. Okay, you can shape it up whichever way. This thing is just fun to use. And one of the things about these erasers is that after a while of using it, they tend to, you know, get a little sticky sometimes. That's when it's kind of time to, you know, it's kind of time to get a new one. They're a magnet for dirt, and they're a magnet for, you know, they'll pick anything up. And once you start using it, it's like you get the issue of where am I going to put it, right? Where it won't get dirty, where it won't stick to anything or stuff like that. So I got this from the Hand Stylus. It's a stylus for the iPad. It's a little cup here that holds the nibs, the replacement nibs for the stylus. I had ordered this back then when I was using the iPad, and the stylus is on the iPad. And basically, I got a genius thought one day of using this to basically house my kneaded eraser, and it works perfect. It just works perfect. You just put it in there, you carry it wherever you go. Little kneaded eraser in that little case right there. Thank you to the makers of the Hand Stylus for this little awesome thing. As far as inking goes, I've been inking a lot with, I used to ink a lot with brushes, but I've taken a break from brushes, and I've been inking a lot with Staedtler pigment liner pens, and this is the brand and the type that I use. I really love this case that this company makes, because basically you open it up and you can have it like just on the desk, just stand up there so that you can choose your pens, right? And it brings a 0.1, a 0.3, 0.5, and 0.7. I usually use 0.5, 0.7, depending on how small I'm drawing. If I'm drawing a little smaller than that and I want to get into details, I'll use the 0.1. But these pens are really good. I find that with some light pressure, you can get a variation in lines. Not huge, obviously, like a brush or like a dip pen, but you get some type of variation as far as line weight using a little bit of pressure with those pens. So that's pretty much it. That's my that's the traditional tools, the analog tools that I'm using at the moment, and hopefully I'll make another one of these videos pretty soon. Stay safe, peace out, and if you like this video, please hit the like button below, and if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, come on man, go for it, subscribe. Thank you for watching. My name is Eric Merced. See you around.